Hi everyone, welcome to this video. This is the second installment in our small series about the restoration of our front suspension, and in this video we'll work on the front hubs and we'll install new front wheel bearings.
These are the front hubs. They came right off the car like this. Studs, bearings are still in it. So now we're going to disassemble these. I'm also going to remove the wheel studs, and this is one that I already removed, and I'll show you how I'm going to remove the rest. So now we're going to disassemble the front hub. We're going to start by removing all of the wheel studs. The only tools that you'll need are a vise and a hammer. The bigger the hammer, the better. A little bit of penetration fluid will help as well. So you want to hit the top of the stud with a hammer, and you want to hit it as hard as you can, because a few short hard blows will work a lot better than a lot of small taps. We'll start with this one. The next thing to do is to remove the grease cap. This one I already had off when I removed the hubs. Make a little washer out, and also the front bearing, the outer one. You can remove the rear bearing. So this is just a socket with an extension on it. Just hit it. This is the inner bearing. Now we have to remove the races. These are hammered into the front hub, and the way to remove these is to use a drift and to hit the races from the back, and I'll try to film on the inside. There are a couple of notches where you can put your drift. I'm not sure if you can see this, but there's one notch there. And there's also a notch there. So you want to put the tip of your drift in that notch and just use a hammer to drive the race out. So I'm going to put my drift in the notch. You want to alternate between both sides. So this is the inner race. Now I'm going to turn it over, and it's just the same principle on this side. You need to find the notches, because they will be filled with grease and they are difficult to find. And here's the outer race as well. So now the hub's completely stripped. So now I'm going to remove all the studs, wire brush it a little bit, and then put it in the bucket with the vinegar, so I can let it soak for a couple of days, and then we can clean this off as well. These are the front hubs after they've been cleaned. There's a little bit of flash rust, but I'll just clean that off before I paint these. So these are the hubs. These are the new wheel studs, and these are made for Ford cars. These are 63 millimeters long, and they have a knurled area of 13.1 millimeters. They have a tread of 12 by 1.5, and the only difference in shank and head between this and the original ones is that these don't have a chamfered area. And to fit these in the front hubs, you have to do a small modification. You have to do a small modification because once you fit these, because the head is a little bit wider, it will hit this internal wall. This is one that's modified a little bit. I'm not sure if you can see it, but I've ground the head a little bit flat. So if I fit now, you have a lot more space in between here. So that's the only modification that you'll need to do to get these to fit your front hubs. And I'm going to fit these by using my vise, and I'll show you how I'm going to do this. Now I'm going to show you how to install the new studs into the front hubs. So this is the front hub. This is one of the modified wheel studs. I'll start off by setting these in place with the ground off edge towards the center. Then I'll give it a small tap, just that it won't move. So this is something that's optional. I'm going to use a little bit of Loctite. So now that there's a little bit of Loctite onto the knurled area, you're going to need a spacer. I'm going to put this over the studs. Now you can close your vise, and this will press it into position. Now, as you can see, the studs is fully seated on the back of the hub. No interference along the center, and studs in place. So this is the hub that's painted with the new wheel studs in. Now we're going to put the new wheel bearings in. I got a Spitfire wheel bearing kit online. We'll start off with the inner bearing. So this is the new inner wheel bearing. So the first thing that we need to do is to install this inner wheel bearing race. Now, the correct way to do this is by using a press or a bearing race installer tool. However, if you don't have any of these, like me, I'm going to show you a nice trick. This is the old bearing race, and you put this on top of the new one, and you can use this as a tool to install it. Make sure that it's seated correctly. It might happen that the race gets stuck. But you can just pull it out. So now you have to pack the bearings. The way to do this is you take a glob of grease in your left hand, and then you take the bearing. And you want to force the grease in between this, you can see there's a small opening here, between this larger opening, between all the rollers. How you do this, you take the bearing, push the grease in between all the rollers. And you know you have enough grease in there if the grease starts coming out on the other side of the rollers, so that's okay. Now we just need to do the same thing with the inner bearing, and then we can mount all the bearings inside of the hub. All the grease that you have left after you've packed the bearings, you put this inside of the hub. You don't have to fill the hub completely because it will need a little bit of room for expansion once the hub gets hot. So that's the way to pack a bearing. Now I'm going to do the same to the other three. Now That's the bearing in position. Here I have a grease seal. This is it. And the felt side goes upwards, so towards the inside of the car. You can use the same technique. This will keep the inner bearing in position. So now we have to install the race for the outer bearing as well. It's just the exact same thing. Put the race in. It's the old race. I think it's seated all the way. You can test this by taking a look to the rear. Now you can put the outer bearing in. This is a Series 1 Europa. This doesn't have an outer bearing seal, just a dewasher. This is a reused one, but I might get new ones. So this is it. This is how to install front hub bearings. It's not, there's not much to it. It looks a lot more complicated than it actually is. So now it's time to mount the new disc brakes to the reconditioned hubs. This is what the original discs looked like when I got them off the car. This is what they look like once I cleaned them up a little bit. They're scrap. So now it's time to mount the new disc brake to the reconditioned hub. This is a nicely grooved disc brake, it's not vented, it's still solid. I've got new bolts and washers. So what you want to pay attention for is that the mounting surfaces of both the hub and the disc are spotless. You don't want any paint on this mounting surface, because otherwise you will have a very big disc runout, and you want to avoid that. So just pull these in. So now the disc has been mounted to the hub. However, the bolts still need to be torqued, but at the moment I don't have a torque wrench that will go that low. So I'm going to get a new torque wrench, and then I'm going to torque these bolts. This is my new torque wrench. It's a Sealy one. It's the STW1011, and it has a pretty wide range. It goes from 7 to 112 newton meters. So it goes from the pretty low stuff to the reasonably high stuff for my car. This one has a 3/8 drive, but I have this small adapter that adapted to half an inch, and I need to torque these to about 33 newton meters. So now, after I've used it, we'll loosen the torque wrench to zero. That way it always stays calibrated, because this one comes with a calibration certificate. And so now we can put these hubs back on the front suspension.
This is the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions or comments, you can post it below or send me an email through my website. You can also subscribe to this YouTube channel so you won't miss any of the upcoming videos. In the next video, we'll restore the front anti-roll bar. I hope I'll see you then. Goodbye.